river of blood. Come, take your abode in us. Cleanse us of every stain and save our souls, O good Lord.
Holy God, holy man, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy man, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy man, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, who is now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. All holy Trinity, have mercy on us, Lord, forgive our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for your name's sake. Glory, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, who is now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. Our God, the Lord, our God, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
That is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen. Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, unto the ages of ages. Amen. Come, let us worship and bow down before God, our King. Come, let us worship and bow down before Christ, God, our King.
Let us
worship and bow down
before
him, Christ, our King
and God.
May the Lord
hear you.
May the Lord hear you in the day of affliction, and the name of God of faith and hope defend you, and send you help from the soul of faith, and may he support you from Zion, and may he never let you be forsaken. May he support you from Zion, and may he never let you be forsaken.
Master, pardon our transgressions. Holy Lord,
Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Save, O Lord, your people and bless your inheritance, granting victory to the faithful over the enemy, and by your cross protecting your commonwealth.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You were lifted up on the cross voluntarily, O Christ our God. Bestow your tender compassion upon you, covenant unity to which you gave your name. Make our faithful governors to be glad in your power, granting them victory against their adversaries. May they have a that alliance which is yours, the shield of peace, the trophy of invincible.
Both now and ever to the ages of ages, amen. O awesome and unshameable protection of good and grace with the old souls, do not despise our petition. Make firm the community of your love, save those whom you have called to rule. Grant the victory from on high. For you gave birth to God and are truly blessed.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for all pious and Orthodox Christians.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for Archbishop and Father Saba.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
You are a merciful God who loves mankind, and to you we give glory. The Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord.
In the name of the Lord, Father, give a blessing.
Glory to the Holy, consubstantial, life-giving, and undivided Trinity, always, now, and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men. O Lord, you shall open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise. O Lord, you shall open my lips, and my mouth shall declare your praise. O Lord, why do those who afflict me multiply? Many are those who rise up against me. Many are those who say to my soul, there is no salvation for him in his God. But you, O Lord, are my protector, my glory, and the one who lifts up my head. I cried to the Lord with my voice, and he heard me from his holy hill. I lay down and slept. I awoke, for the Lord will help me. I will not be afraid of 10,000s of people who set themselves against me all around. Arise, O Lord, and save me, O my God, for you struck all those who were foolishly at enmity with me. You broke the teeth of sinners. Salvation is the Lord, and your blessing is upon your people. I lay down and slept. I awoke, and the Lord will help me.
O Lord, do not rebuke me in your wrath, nor chastise me in your anger. For your arrows have fixed in me, and your hand rest on me. There is no healing in my flesh because of your wrath. There is no peace in my bones because of my sin. For my transgressions rise up over my head, like a heavy burden they weigh heavily on me. My wounds grow foul and fester because of my fall. I suffer misery, and I utterly bow down. I go all the day long with a sad face. For my loins were filled with mockeries, and there is no healing in my flesh. I am affected and greatly humbled. I roar because of the groaning of my heart. Lord, all my desire before you, my going is well hidden from you. My heart is in trouble, my strength failed me, and the light of my eyes even is not with me. My friends and neighbors draw near and stand against me, and my near kin stand far off. And those who seek my soul use violence, and those who seek evil from me speak folly, and they meditate on deceit all the day long. But I, like a deaf man, do not hear, and I am like a mute who does not open his mouth. I am like a man who does not hear and has no reproofs in his mouth. For in you, O Lord, I hope you will hear, O Lord my God. For I said, let not my enemies rejoice over me, for when my foot was shaken, they boasted against me. For I am weary from my wounds, and my pains continue with me. For I will declare my transgressions, and I will live in anguish about my sin. But my enemies that live and are becoming stronger than I, and those within all are unjustly and multiply. Those who repay evil for good have slandered me, but because of pursue righteousness, and they threw away my love as though it was a stinking corpse. Do not forsake me, O Lord, O my God. Do not depart from me. Give heed to me. Help me, O Lord, of my salvation. Do not forsake me, O Lord, O my God. do not depart from me. Give heed to my helping, to help me, O Lord, of my salvation.
O God, my glory, to me, thee, my soul thirsts for thee, how often my flesh thirsts for thee, in a desolate and fast-fed waterless land. So in the holy place I appear before thee, to see thy power and thy glory, because thy mercy is better than life, my lips shall praise thee. Thus I will bless thee in my life, I will lift up my hand to thy name. May my soul be filled as if with marrow and fatness, and my mouth shall sing praise to thee with the lips filled with rejoicing. If I remember thee on my head, I meditate on thee at daybreak. For thou art my upright and shelter of thy wings, I will greatly rejoice. My soul follows close behind thee. Thy right hand takes hold of me, but they seek for my soul in vain. They shall go into the lower parts of the earth. They shall be given over to the edge of the sword. They shall be a portion for the foxes. But the king shall be glad in God. All who swear by him shall be praised, for the mouth that speaks unrighteousness stings the scoff. I meditated on thee at daybreak, for thou art my helper, and in the shelter of thy wings I will greatly rejoice. My soul follows close behind thee, thy right hand takes hold of me. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and for ages of ages. Amen. Hallelujah, 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 glory to thee, O God. Hallelujah, 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 glory to thee, O God. Hallelujah, 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 glory to thee, O God. To the lace of, to the lace of, to the lace of. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and for ages of ages. Amen.
O Lord God of my salvation, I cry out at night before you. Never have prayer come before you. Incline your ear to my supplication, O Lord. For my soul is filled with sorrows, and my soul draws near to Hades. I am counted among those who go down into the pit. I am like a helpless man free among the dead, like slain death, the throne, down and sleeping in a grave, whom you remember no more, but they are removed from your hand. They laid me in the lowest pit, in the dark places, in the shadow of death. Your wrath was rested upon me, and you brought all your fellows over me. You removed my iniquities from far, far from me. They made me an abomination among themselves. I was betrayed and did not go forth. My eyes weeping from poverty, O Lord, I cried out to you through the whole day long. I spread out my hands to you. Will you work wonders for the dead? The visitors is raised, and I'm up and acknowledge you. Shall anyone in the grave describe your mercy and the truth and the destruction? Shall your wonders be known in darkness, or your righteousness in the forgotten land? But I cry to you, O Lord, and in the morning my prayer shall come near to you. Why, Lord, do you reject my soul and turn your way face away from me? I am worn and in troubles from my youth, but having been exalted, I was humbled and brought to you into despair. Your fierce anger passed over me, and your terrors have greatly troubled me. They compassed me like waters all the day long. They surround me at once. You remove far from me my friend, neighbor, and friend, and my acquaintances because of my misery. Your power and your glory because of your mercy is better than life, and I shall praise you. Thus I will bless you in my life. I will lift up my hand in your name. May my soul be filled. O Lord of my salvation, I cry out to you day and night before you. Let my prayer come before you. Incline your ear to my supplication, O Lord.
Bless the Lord of my soul and everything within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord of my soul. Forgive not all his rewards. Who is merciful to all your transgressions. Who heals all your diseases. Who redeems your life from corruption. Who crowns you with mercy and compassion. Who satisfies you with your desires. Who takes in your earth. Youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord shows mercy and judgment to all who are wrong. He made known his ways to Moses, the things he willed to the sons of Israel. The Lord is compassionate and merciful, slow to anger, and abounding in mercy. He will not become angry to the end, nor will he be wrathful forever. He will not deal with us according to our sins, nor reward us according to our transgressions. For according to the height of heaven and from earth, so the Lord reigns in mercy over those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so he removes our transgressions from us. As a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him. For he knows how he formed us. He remembers we are dust as for a man. His days are like grass as a flower of the field, so he flourishes. For the wind passes through it, and it shall not remain. It shall no longer know its place, but where the mercy of the Lord is from age to age upon those who fear him, and his righteousness upon children's children, to such as keep his covenant and remember his commandments to do them. The Lord prepared his throne in heaven, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, all you his angels, mighty in strength to do his word, so as to hear the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, all you his hosts, his ministers who do his will. Bless the Lord, all you his works in all places of his dominion. Bless the Lord, my soul, in all places of his dominion. Bless the Lord, of my soul.
Father, Lord, hear my prayer. Give ear to my supplication in your truth. Answer me in your righteousness. Do not enter into judgment with your servant, for no one living shall become righteous in your sight. For the enemy persecuted my soul. He humbled my life to be ground. He caused me to dwell in dark places as one long dead, and my spirit was within me. My heart was troubled within me. I remembered the days of old, and I meditated on all your works. I meditated on the works of your hands. I spread out my hands to you. My soul thirsts for you like a waterless land. Hear me speedily, O Lord. My spirit faints within me. Turn not your face from me, lest I become like those who go down into the pit. Cause me to hear your mercy in the morning, but for I hope in you. Make me know, O Lord, the way whereas I should walk, for I lift up my soul to you. Deliver me from my enemies, O Lord, for to you I flee for refuge. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. Your good spirit shall guide me in the land of uprightness. For your name's sake, O Lord, give me life in your righteousness. You shall bring my soul out of affliction. In your mercy, you shall destroy my enemies. You shall utterly destroy all who afflict my soul, for I am your servant. Answer me in your righteousness. Do not enter into judgment with your servant. Answer me in your righteousness. Do not enter into judgment with your servant. Your good spirit shall guide me in the land of uprightness. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, but now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen.
Alleluia, 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 Lord, to you, God.
Alleluia, 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 Lord, we give you, O God.
Alleluia, 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 Lord, to you, God. Oh, all the glory to you.
Peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Peace from above for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For peace in the whole world, for the stability of holy churches, of God, for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Archbishop and Father Salvas, the Honorable Presbyter of the Beatitude of Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our country, for the President, for all public service, and for the armed forces everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this parish and city, for every city, down for the faithful live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For favorable weather, for an abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by land, sea, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the captives, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering your holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, that thou art the most ever virgin Mary with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves for another in our own life to Christ our God. Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages. Yeah. Deon priti paradihosi vlepe primaton erasta podia tafta angoni prisameno felge aporeston psichi ti didascalo ki afta to
and let him who has no sword sell his mantle and buy one.
For I tell you that the scripture must be fulfilled in me, and he was reckoned with transgressors. For what is written about me has its fulfillment. And they said, look, Lord, here are two swords. And he said to them, it is enough. And he came out and went, as was his custom, to the Mount of Olives. And the disciples followed him.
And he is greatly glorified.
Peter, your disciples, and by this you set them straight on the course of God, although refusing initially to be washed. Peter submits and obeys the divine command, and is washed by you, and now he entreats you earnestly, beseeching that you grant us your great mercy.
Yeah.
God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
I pray that all holy, pure, most blessed, and gloriously, that they all go, most and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, Lord.
For you are the King of peace and the Savior of our souls, and to you we give glory. Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Receiving the bread of his, in his hand, the betrayer, in secret, extends those very things received from the priest of Christ of him, who had fashioned hand on the own hands, and he remained victorious for Judas.
In Jesus' name. As we all draw near with fear to the mystical table, let us receive the bread with pure souls, remaining beside the Master, that we may see how he washes the feet of the disciples and dries them with the towel. And let us do to all we have seen, being subject to one another and washing one another's feet. For Christ himself has ordered this, as he declared it before to his disciples. But one did not listen. Judas has stayed in the name.
Judas has stayed in the name.
On the 25th of this month, we commemorate the Holy Apostle Evangelist Mark. On this day, we commemorate the consecration of the August Shrine of the Holy and Allah, Chief Apostle Peter, which is next to the Most Holy Great Church. On this day, we commemorate our Father among the saints, Macedonius, Patriarch of Constantinople. On this day, we commemorate the Holy Martyr, who believed in Christ through St. George. On this day, we commemorate the Holy and Righteous Martyrs and Anchorites. On this day, we commemorate the Righteous Father, Sylvester of Nora. By the intercession of the saints of Christ, God, have mercy on us. Amen.
On holy and great Thursday, the godly fathers who have arranged all things well, received from the divine apostles and the sacred gospels, and in turn handed down to us, that today we should celebrate four things: the sacred washing of the feet, the mystical supper, that is the tradition of what we know as the apostle mysteries of Holy Communion, the high priestly prayer, and finally the betrayal itself.
At evening, God washes the disciples' feet, whose foot once walked in Eden before dusk. Dunk the supper that the Lord's Pascha brings in Pascha new, the Master's body blood. Prayer and great chair, drops of blood. O Christ, drop from your face, and bleeding to escape from death, by this you cheat the foe. What need of swords of strays or hearing folk? Gaze to one who longs to die for world's release. Bind that fast in ineffable compassion, O Christ our God, have mercy on us. Amen.
Babylon the servants did not cringe at the furnace fire, but when cast into the midst of the flame, they were refreshed and sang the hymn, "Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our Father."
Bringing all danger for their ancestral laws, the blessed young men in Babylon splat this day for thee upon the king's unreasonable decree, and being joined to the fire by which they were not consumed, they sang a hymn worthy of God the ruler. Sing again to the Lord of his works, and exalt him beyond measure unto all the ages.
From whom
you betray you, and eating your bread, your divine body, he lifted up his heel against you, O Christ, and knew not to cry out, sing God into the Lord all you his works, and exalt him beyond measure unto all the
Thank you.
mercy on us and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
I pray for our holy, for the most blessed and glorious thing, that they are both us and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. All the powers of death and praise and offer our glory to you, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, unto the ages of ages. My Savior, now I see thee, your wedding hall decorated. Thy have not the wedding garment needed for me to enter it. Make this raiment of my soul brightly shine. Giver of light and save me.
For he for us
who at the supper did his hand without his.
symbols. Let everything that trees praise the Lord. Judas the servant and defrauder, the disciple and the betrayer, the friend and detractor, was proven by his deeds. He followed the teacher and privately he plotted the betrayal. He said to himself, once I betray him, the collection money will be mine. He had wanted the costly ointment to be sold, and he plotted that Jesus be arrested through a ploy. He gave him a kiss and gave up the Christ, who followed like a sheep to the slaughter. As the only compassionate Lord who loves humanity.
Glory to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the
you belong. plead our morning prayers to the Lord.
Mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Mercy.
For a perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless day, let us ask the Lord. For an angel of peace and faithful guide and guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask the Lord.
For
forgiveness and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask the Lord. Good and beneficial to our souls and for peace for the world, let us ask the Lord. That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask the Lord. Let us ask for a Christian end to our life, peaceful without shame and suffering, and for a good defense before the awesome judgment seat of Christ. Remembering our all holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves, one another, and our whole life to Christ our God. For you are the God of mercy and compassion and love for mankind. To you we give glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Peace be with you all. Let us bow our heads to the Lord. Engaged, you oversee all creation, to you we bow both in spirit and in body, to you we pray, O Holy of Holies. Extend your unseen hand from your holy dwelling place and bless us all. And if we have sinned willfully or unintentionally, as a good and loving God, forgive and granting us both your earthly and heavenly gifts. For yours it is to show mercy and to save us, O our God. And to you we give glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of the world. Today the evil council against Christ has gathered together, and they plotted vain things against him to deliver, to bind him to Pilate, and put him to death, even though he is innocent. Today Judas has put the noose of money around his own neck, and he deprives himself of life, both temporal and divine. Today Caiaphas is not of his own accord prophesying. He says to him, it is expedient that one man should die for the people, for he came to suffer for our sins, that he might free us from slavery to the enemy, as he is good and loves humanity.
That he sells at any
Against me the divine evil swore me. Your behavior is full of deceit, O Judas, you transgressor of the law. Sick with love for money, you gained for yourself a hatred for humanity. You were enamored with wealth, so why become the disciple of the one who teaches about poverty? Because you loved him then, why did you sell him the priceless one and deliver him over to a bloody death? Shudder, oh sovereign Lord, quake and cry aloud, unresentful Lord, glory to
Oh, now and ever. that you may bear fruit for I am the body of thine.
It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to sing to your name, O Most High, to proclaim your mercy in the morning and your truth at night.
I will
settle them each in his inheritance, then each in his land. Keep it all. Pray and return to the Lord your God. And Judah Christ know.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. We're at what we would consider to be the halfway, midway point of Holy Week. I'm not going to ask my chanters if they can feel it.
They heard.
Because I know you can. I'm asking all of us. How much of Holy Week do we know? How's it going? And I ask that question because I see a few of the faces for the first time tonight. I see others that I've seen almost every night, which is a beautiful thing. This is how we should go through the Holy Week, as much as we can possibly take. I'm not going to ask the reason why it's some people's first night. That's not up to me. But it's important for us to understand. Somebody was sharing with me today, Father, I haven't been able to get to the services. I really feel bad. I've done this. I can't do this. I'm like, look. Don't apologize to me. I'm not your judge. I'm appreciative for any time somebody comes. I love them. I'm a people person. That's just how I'm built. But the important thing is that you know whether you could have made it before or whether we prioritized other things ahead of these services. Whether we've prioritized other things ahead of us. And why is that important? Not to make anyone feel bad. That's not my goal. My goal is not to make anyone feel bad, but to encourage that maybe we can reprioritize. And I say this because the church itself is giving us hymns within the church that actually do make us feel bad. They make me feel bad. And, you know, some people would say that I have my life prioritized within the church correctly. I would disagree with that, but some people might say that. And so we would, these hymns tonight, oh my goodness, they're chastising to the core about how somebody got it wrong. And you've heard, if you've been here a few nights, you've heard the kind of the slippery slope that is Judas's life. You've heard it. And this whole week, we kind of villainize this man. And rightfully so, in one sense, in the most major sense, that he had everything right at the tip, right there. He was right in front of him. He had the kingdom of heaven. He not only had the kingdom of heaven, but let's remind ourselves that God, when the rich young ruler would not give away his fortune, And the disciples were saying, Lord, what about us? You know, he said the rich man is gonna be harder for a rich person to go through the eye of the needle, a camel go through the eye of the needle, than for a rich person to enter the kingdom of God. And the disciples looked at him and said, what about us? We don't have anything. And Jesus says, no, behold, you've left it all behind. You're gonna be on the 12 tribes, on the 12 thrones in heaven, judging the 12 tribes of Israel. That's where Jesus left. He left a glory beyond measure. It's unbelievable what a throne in the heavens would look like. I couldn't even imagine. I see thrones on this earth and they look magnificent. Whatever thrones they are. And I realize that they're only earthly thrones, but they still look magnificent. I can't even imagine what a throne in heaven would look like, promised by God himself. I can't even imagine what it was like, what it would have been like to be in that locked room with Jesus this evening as he took off his garment to wash the feet of the disciples, and Judas was there. I can't even imagine what it was like to sit at table as he broke bread with the disciples for the last time before his return and said, this is no longer bread. This is my body. This is my blood. I can't imagine that being at that moment. The closest we get is here, where we are now. The treachery is not calculable. It's not able to be calculated. The treachery of Judas, what he left behind. It's just not able to be. And I'm not trying to villainize him. It's just the truth. There's nobody that left what he left. The way he left it. There's just nobody. And the scare tactic of the church here is to say, don't be like it. You have everything. You have everything. You have, in some ways, what the church is telling us, you have even more than what the apostles had at that moment in time. Why? Because you know the truth. You know the end of the story. They didn't. We are living in the basking in the grace of the Lord's resurrection. The disciples, the apostles of that time did not have that knowledge. They didn't know. They were told, but they didn't understand it. And this is not the time that we're supposed to fool ourselves. The Old Testament reading bears witness to it. Why do the ways, this is the prophecy of Jeremiah, why do the ways of the treacherous prosper? I'll give you a 21st century version of that question. Why do bad things happen to good people and good things happen to bad people? That's the 21st century translation of that question. Why do the ways of the treacherous prosper? That's what the question is. Not the new under the sun. The question still remains. The trick, though, and this is the evil one's trick in us, because whenever we ask a question, why do good things happen to bad people, we exclude ourselves, don't we? Why do bad things happen to good people? We think to ourselves that we're good, don't we? The church doesn't let us do that. It will never let us do that. Because when I say the word bad people, I always say people that are worse than me. It's just the truth. It's what I think. Maybe you're no different. Maybe you think the same thing. Bad people. That just means people that are worse than I am. You know, when we're on the road, the person that's an idiot is the one going slower than you, and the person that's a maniac is the one that's going faster than you. And all of you, I become the fulcrum. When did that happen? When did I become the place where this turns? No, it's God. And when the rich young ruler that I just spoke about went to God and said, "Good teacher, what must I do?" He said, "Why do you call me good? Only God is good." Are you saying that I'm God? Are you ready to do what I'm about to ask of you? I'm not telling you that bad things don't happen to good people, in my estimation. I'm not telling you that good things don't happen to bad people. What I'm telling you is that the church doesn't allow us to think that somehow we deserve something, that we're entitled to something. Not tonight. Not tonight. Everything we have is a gift. Not an entitlement. It is an offering of love from the one who owes us nothing. He owes us yet he still gave everything to us. Tonight I feel like a whining, sniveling little kid. That's what I feel like when I read these hymns and realize what our Lord actually did for us. That's the way I feel. And it's good once in a while to feel like that. Because it lets us look at the Lord differently. He is no longer that didn't heal me when I asked him, or didn't do this for my loved one when I asked him, or didn't do this. He is the God that has given me everything, including the strength and courage to get through the thing that I asked him to take from me. Yes, he asks of us is so small compared. all we've got, but it's so small compared to what he has given us. And when we look at God that way, and this week just lets us do that so beautifully, when we look at God that way, it is no longer a situation where we say, oh, okay, why this, why that, why? No, we don't ask the why anymore. We ask, what, Lord, can I do more for me? In the greatness of everything you've given me, how much more can I give you? And if the answer is nothing, then God bless you for giving everything you've got. But for me, I always seem to feel like I'm offering more. There's always something more that I can offer. Judas was done giving. He was done. The hymn that kills me, and I pointed it out to Gregory, it just kills me. Tony chanted tonight. He sells the master for a cheap price, strikes a bargain on buyer's term for the one, capital O, who is being sold, and doesn't even haggle over the price. They said 30 pieces of silver, and he said, fine, I'll take it. Judas was done giving and was looking from the rest of that moment until he realized what he did. He was looking only to take. Our job as Christians is to not be takers. Receivers, fine, but not takers. You receive, you're receiving graciously and joyfully because it's a gift. You take. It's something that you feel your own. Our job is to be mainly givers. And then in God's time, we can be gracious receivers. This week is a week of giving. Especially our time. And let us keep that in our minds as we continue to be in the place where God is. As he said in his gospel, the ones who are the Gentiles, they're going to lord everything over you. They're going to exercise lordship. I am the master, and I'm here as one who serves. In other words, I'm the one that you need to be giving to, and I'm giving to you. Let us follow the example of our Lord and seek to give more of ourselves to him this week, as he has given everything to us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us rise and we will complete our service. Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord,
have
mercy,
Lord, have
mercy.
Then we pray for all pious and Orthodox Christians. Pray for Archbishop and Father Savas. Then we pray for our brethren, the priests, hierarchs, deacons, and monastics, and all our brotherhood in Christ. Then we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, protection, forgiveness, and remission of the sins of the servants of God, all pious Christians living and visiting in this city, the parishioners, the members of the parish council, and Philopos members in every ministry of this parish, the donors and benefactors of this holy sanctuary. And let us again pray for the blessed and ever memorable founders of this holy church, for all of our fathers and mothers, brothers and sisters who are asleep here in the Lord, for the Orthodox everywhere. Let us again pray for those who do charitable work and for those who serve this holy house, for those who labor, teach, and sing, and for all the people here present who await your great and rich mercy. For you are a merciful God who loves mankind, and to you we give glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages. above.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Christ, for always, now and forever, to the ages of ages. May he who out of surpassing goodness demonstrated the excellent way of humility by washing his disciples' feet and who condescended to us even to be crucified and buried, Christ our true God, through the intercession of his most pure and holy mother, the power of the precious and life-giving cross, protection of the honorable body of the powers of heaven, supplication of the honorable glorious prophet and forerunner John the Baptist, the holy glorious and praiseworthy apostles, the holy glorious and triumphant martyrs of our righteous and God-bearing fathers, and the holy righteous ancestors of God, the Jodhimanana, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for you, good and merciful God, who loves and kind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.
May the Holy Trinity bless, protect, and keep all of you. I assume, possibly correctly, that most, if not all of you, are also here not only for the service, but also to receive holy unction. So because of that, I'm going to ask those that are going to receive holy unction to please kneel at this time while I read the prayer of anointing. So I would ask everyone to please kneel while I read the prayer of anointing. Let us pray to the Lord. O Holy Father, the healer and physician of our souls and bodies, who sent your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to heal every infirmity and every disease and to deliver from death, heal these your servants from their ailments of body and soul and endow them with life by the grace of your Christ, through the intercession of our All-Holy Lady, the Theotokos and Ever-Virgin Mary, by the power of the precious and life of the cross, the protection of the honorable body of the powers of heaven, supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner John the Baptist, of the holy glorious, a lot of the apostles, of the holy glorious and triumphant martyrs, of our saintly and God-bearing fathers, of the holy unmercenaries and healers, Cosmas and Damianos, Curus and John, Samson and Diomedes, Mokius and Icatos, Pandelemur and Emolaus, Dalileus and Trifon, and the holy righteous ancestors of God, Jewish Panana, and of all the saints. For you are God, the source of healing, to you we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Okay, so the way this is going to work, you may rise or sit. The way this is going to work, I'm going to have everyone come down the center aisle to venerate the icon of the Mystical Supper, and then you will come process over here where I will anoint you. As I announced earlier today, you will be anointed on your forehead, your chin, your cheeks. I was taught in November, I had never seen an anointing like this before, but I was taught by Metropolitan Sabas to also anoint the neck. I had never seen that before, but this is what I'm going to do. So I'm going to anoint the forehead, chin, cheeks, your neck, and then both sides of your hands. And if you have a place that is ailing you on your body that you would like me to anoint that is easily accessible, I will also anoint that if you would like. Please process down the center aisle to venerate the icon, and then just be patient as I put some chanting music on. Oh, incidentally, just because it's been my practice to announce the next service, tomorrow morning at 8 a.m., tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. will be our vesperal liturgy of the Mystical Supper. It's also the liturgy that we consecrate the host that is taken to all the sick throughout the year. So we will do that tomorrow at 8 a.m., and then tomorrow night at 6:30, we will again have the crucifixion service of the 12 Gospels.
Since that we